Our investigation of the Gunner Mercenary faction next brings us to the Green Tech Genetics building in downtown Cambridge. If you try to enter this building before you visit Virgil and the Glowing Sea, you find that the door is locked. But after visiting Brian Virgil, you get the quest Hunter/Hunted. With this quest, you are to track down a courser so that you can kill him and remove the courser chip from inside his brain. I know, a little bit morbid. The hunt starts when you reach the ruins of the CIT. Once here, you pick up a faint courser signal on your Pip-Boy. The signal gets stronger as you near really the only tall skyscraper in this part of Cambridge. It's a greenish color skyscraper off in the distance, and you'll get to where you want to go. The path is fraught with peril. There are quite a few raider encampments that you have to pass through to get to Green Tech Genetics. As we walk around to the front of the building to access the main door, the signal gets strongest. Once inside, we're where we need to go and we can turn off the signal. Now, there's a lack of information about Green Tech Genetics before the war, and that's super frustrating. No terminals in this building talk about this company's pre-war history. The only bit of information we get about this company and this building comes from one terminal entry in the Robco Sales and Service Center that we get after installing the Automatron DLC. In that terminal, we learn that the CEO of Green Tech Genetics is a man named Ahmed Mendy. When I did my video on that place, I talked about how I hoped we could find out more information about Ahmed, but I've done my research for this video and no, there is no more information. We can deduce from the name that this company had something to do with genetic research, but what kind? How did they make money? Did they have any contracts with the government? We just don't know. But we do know that the Gunners have taken up residence here. Even in this lobby, we see Gunner bodies sprawled over banisters. But we didn't come here looking for Gunners. We came here looking for a courser. What are the Gunners doing here? Why did the courser come here? Let's continue onward to further explore this building to see if we can answer these questions. I brought MacCready with me. He's a former Gunner, and I thought that maybe he would have some interesting flavor dialogue when exploring this place, but I was sadly disappointed. He had really nothing to say. As we arrive on the upper floor, we hear a voice over the loudspeaker.
The courser's on the second floor. Kill on sight. Send reinforcements to the lobby in case there are more.
Who is that guy? Well, it's clear that he's a gunner and is likely in charge of the gunners at this building. However, he does not have a name. One of the leaders of the gunner faction here in the Commonwealth is Captain Wes, based out of the Gunner's Plaza. We did a video exploring that place earlier. And there are some people who think that Captain Wes himself is speaking over the loudspeaker here. However, the subtitles have no name listed. This is very strange. It's one of the few moments in the game where there's not some name listed when somebody speaks. But in his dialogue, the name is completely blank, so we don't know who it is. I compared the voice actor performing over this loudspeaker to the voice actor on Wes's holotape.
429er, retreat back to HQ immediately. That's an order. Over.
Kill on sight. Send reinforcements to the lobby in case there are more.
And you can hear that they are the same voice. However, this doesn't really mean anything, because Bethesda will use the same voice actors for many of the Raider, Settler, Scavenger, and even Gunner voices. So, we ultimately don't know who this is. Suffice it to say that this is some unnamed Gunner leader who is in this building at the time, and whom we likely kill, or whom the Courser likely kills, during the course of this encounter. Now, the voice over the intercom sent Gunners to the lobby. Those are the Gunners that we just killed. But the voice also mentioned a courser on the second floor. This is likely the courser that we are hunting. And this courser is apparently hostile to the Gunners. We can see off in the distance a laser gun fight that we are not a part of. The Gunners must be trying to defend themselves from the courser. The elevator to the right is non-functional. We'll unlock this later on. And we can then go downstairs to the bottom floor of the courtyard, which is uninteresting save for a terminal in the far corner of the room. From this terminal, we can disable disable any other turrets that are attached to it. And here, we learn a little bit more about why the gunners are here to begin with. The first note is called Materials Gathered. The gunners came to GreenTech Genetics to salvage material for transport back to HQ. HQ must be Gunner's Plaza. In Gunner's Plaza, we see them processing such material, including a safe. Now, it's annoying that they use such a generic and vague term as material in this terminal entry. It would be much more interesting to learn exactly why they were here. Were they looking for technology? Maybe a bit of genetic code? Could their reason for being here somehow explain why many of them have their blood types tattooed on their foreheads? Are they dabbling in genetic engineering and needed to come here for some pre-war technology? Or is it just a simple smash-and-grab operation looking for chems, caps, and scrap? Whatever it is they're looking for, they do not elaborate, but they do say that they're storing it all in the lobby to await further processing. They're actually concerned about looting too much. Whoever the gunner boss is at this tower is going to reach out to Gunner HQ regarding the quantity of material that they're gathering so that they don't gather too much. That is surprising. You'd think that they would salvage as much from this building as they possibly could, even if it took multiple trips. How can you overdo it? And we also learned that they have long-term plans for this building. In the next entry called Defenses, we learn that in the short time that they have occupied the GreenTech Genetics building, they've already set up some defenses. These are the wall-mounted machine gun turrets and other turrets that we've already encountered. We'll find a few more as we explore this building. I think they would only go to the effort of setting up such elaborate defenses if they planned to stay here for a long time. This, after all, is the Gunner MO. For example, when they took the Hub City auto wreckers, they used it as a base of operations from which to start new campaigns. When they took Quincy, they didn't just loot it and leave the place, they occupied it. The gunners are finding places of strategic importance to use as new permanent bases from which they can grow. So this GreenTech Genetics operation had two steps. Step number one, salvage as much of this quote-unquote material that they can find and bring it back to headquarters for processing. And step number two, set up defenses and then occupy the building. Now, as we've been exploring, the unnamed gunner voice over the loudspeaker realizes that the courser is not the only one there.
What's going on down there? How many are we dealing with?
He has detected our presence. These poor gunners are now fighting a war on two fronts. The courser upstairs, and now you. This hallway leads to a stairway where the strange voice greets us again.
The courser is now on the third floor. Reports of the second intruder in the east wing near the courtyard.
Rounding the stairway corner, we can take care of the gunners on the next floor. In one of the bathroom stalls, we see some blocks that spell the word Gary. In my game, G, A, and R were in the left bathroom stall, and the Y was in the middle bathroom stall. I'm not sure how this block got knocked over there, but they all, together, clearly spell the word Gary. This is a nod to Fallout 3, and specifically to Vault 108. Heading through the next room, we can take care of even more gunners.
Now that's what I call a confirmed kill.
And they just keep coming. The courser has gotten these gunners in a frenzied state. Heading through the door, we can shoot another gunner on the ramp.
Barricade stairwells and hallways if you haven't already.
The gunners are trying to do everything they can to contain this infiltration to keep you from reaching the top. As we pass through this hallway, we notice a triggered Tesla trap on the ceiling. This must be one of the traps that the gunners placed. I wonder if the courser triggered it, or if they never had a chance to activate it. We can head through the next broken room to come out of a doorway and right into another firefight between the gunners and the courser. That was on the floor above us, but there are gunners on this floor as well. They shoot at you from both floors, and one of them has a missile launcher.
Oh no! Arms are pretty bad.
When done, we can go across the bridge and through the next room.
We've lost contact with sectors 2 and 4.
You just cleared Sector 2, and it's likely that the Courser cleared Sector 4. That was the firefight that we saw a moment ago. Across from us is a locked door with a bunch of signs that say Restricted Area. Here we find evidence of the Courser at work inside our two gunner bodies. There's also a booby-trapped explosives box on one of the cabinets.
It's absolutely nasty. What the hell is it?
Now, this was a restricted room pre-war, but we really have no indication as to what they were doing here. The room is just filled with high-tech looking machinery and consoles. That's about as much story as we get. Out of the room and down the hallway, we find even more gunners killed by the Courser. Now, in the next room, the ceiling has fallen down to create a ramp. As you get close, you'll likely alert some of the gunners. You can wait for them to come around and through the door, which will make for more easy sniping.
This won't take long.
Who's there?
And then head up the ramp to deal with the rest. Now, the hallway outside this room goes in a big loop. We're gonna turn left around the wall and through the door, but first we deactivate the pulse mine.
Okay, that looked like it hurt.
In the room to the right, we find a missile and a stealth boy. And at the end of the hall, we can turn left to go back to the first hallway that had the Nuka-Cola machine. That completes the loop. To continue forward, we go across the sky bridge, only to find another gunfight break out above us between the Courser and the gunners.
Fall back to original position. Courser, clear the elevator.
At the end of the sky bridge, the gunners come back down towards you. They go across another bridge and around the corner to try and track you.
Find them! Find them!
Once dead, we can go through the room to the left to find a chalkboard with three X's drawn on it with chalk. Also on the chalkboard are three bullet indents and a splattering of some sort of liquid. Now, I think it's clear that this wasn't just target practice. The fact that there is a smattering of liquid means that something biological splashed up against this wall. I think the most likely scenario is that three people were executed here. Somebody set another person against this wall, possibly a prisoner, and then shot them in the head execution style. They did this three times, explaining the three bullet holes in the chalkboard and explaining the blood splatter. Now, the three X's could be one X for each of the executed people, and the clipboard may be part of this scene as well. Maybe the person was taking stock of prisoners, making sure that the right people were executed. Now, how does this weave into our story? Well, I don't think it really does. The door to this building was locked if you tried to access it before you got the quest. This means that sometime between then and now, the gunners are the ones that unlocked this. Now, this blood splatter, however, is extremely old. It's not bright red. In fact, it doesn't even look brown. It looks like it's gotten crusty, gray, and dirty over the years, which means that this event happened long ago. It's possible that the pre-war inhabitants of this office building killed themselves or killed each other. However, I think the X's on the chalkboard and the clipboard tell us that this probably happened sometime after the bombs fell. Maybe over the course of 200 years, raiders had occupied this place and used it as a headquarters where they kidnapped people and executed them. Or maybe there's no real explanation, like many of the chalk drawings at the Parsons State Sane Asylum and the Poseidon Energy Plant. They may have no explanation whatsoever and are just set decorations. Heading out this room and down a hallway, we can explore more office rooms. In one, we find two more blocks and a magic eight ball. The blocks spell I and U, but with the eight ball between them, it spells I-H-U. And then we find a fork and a knife. Okay, I get it. It means I ate you, as in I devoured you and digested you. Is this just a joke, or does it have some sort of lore significance? Well, I suppose we could conclude that the markings we just discovered might be the remnants of cannibal executions. I don't think we have any evidence that super mutants can spell, and there's no super mutant decorations here, so maybe we're talking about a gang of post-war raider cannibals that occupied this building at some time over the past 200 years. They kidnapped people, executed them against that wall, and then ate them, and were so pleased with themselves about this that they spelled the words, "I ate you," with a knife and a fork on a desk. Okay. I realize that I'm overthinking this. It probably doesn't mean anything and may just be a nice little flourish from Bethesda. After exploring these rooms, we can exit to the balcony where the raiders came at us from before. A gunfight breaks out above us.
The courser's after the girl. Anyone alive needs to get up to the top floor immediately. That's an order!
The courser's going after the girl. Okay, part of this is starting to make more sense. The courser is here for the girl. That means that the girl must be an escaped synth. But why do the gunners have an escaped synth? The gunners aren't really known for kidnapping. Raiders are. They kidnap people and then turn those people into raiders by force. We learned that from Judge Zeller at the East Boston Preparatory School. And raiders will kidnap people, murder them, and steal all their belongings. But gunners don't really do that. They think bigger. Their moves are always tactical. So why would they kidnap this girl? Did they know that she was a synth? If so, were they trying to reverse engineer synths? Or maybe the Institute hired the gunners? I know, it sounds weird, but think about it. Remember, in my video on Hallucigen, we learned that the gunners were there because they had been hired by someone to retrieve technology from the Hallucigen building. At the time, I theorized that this must have been the Institute. The Brotherhood of Steel has their own army and their own scribes, but the Institute uses mercenaries. They've used them in the past, and they're known to use informants in the Commonwealth. Maybe the Institute hired these gunners to kidnap an escaped synth. I realize that the Institute has an entire bureau dedicated to doing just this thing, the Synth Retention Bureau. But I propose that Father hired these gunner mercenaries to kidnap a synth to keep it safe in a specific location where they could send a courser to retrieve the synth as bait to lure you. Father sends this courser to kill all of the gunners solely for your benefit. Remember, we're here to kill the courser to retrieve the chip in its head so that we can use the synth relay to gain access to the Institute. Now, we know that Father has been watching you from the moment that you left Vault 111. We know that many of these chance meetings that you've had with people like Kellogg have actually been carefully orchestrated. Maybe this one was as well. He can't just give you a courser chip because then he would scare you off. He needs you to think that you're finding your own way into the Institute, that you're doing so without the Institute knowing. Sure, he has to sacrifice 2 synths to get you into the Institute, but in the grand scheme of things, it's a small price to pay. And sure, maybe some of the Institute scientists might object. Justin Io, for example, might not like the idea of wasting 2 synths on one of Father's side projects. But who says that the Institute has to know about it? Who says Justin Io is Father's confidant? Maybe Father is doing this whole Vault 111 side experiment on a whim, without anyone else in the Institute knowing. Maybe he hired the gunners because he has to make it look like a routine mission to deploy a courser into a hostile location to retrieve a synth, so that if that courser dies, no one asks any questions. The place was filled with gunners. The destruction of the courser was always possible. And sadly, at the same time, the synth they were trying to rescue was damaged beyond repair or escaped back into the Commonwealth. But you, the sole survivor, you still get the courser chip, which was Father's plan from the very beginning. And nobody knows that everyone is really a pawn in Father's game. Only the gunners know that something has gone horribly wrong. Now, the one thing this can't explain is why the gunners, knowing that they were being pursued by a courser, would not just hand the girl over. If I was leading this cadre of gunners and I knew that a courser was pursuing me just to get the girl back, I'd say, sure, take the girl. I'd leave the girl behind, leave for a while, and then once the courser left with the synth, go back and retake Green Tech Genetics. What this theory does not explain is why the gunners are fighting to the last man. After disarming a laser tripwire and a fragmentation grenade bouquet, we can ascend the stairs up into the next section. We can kill the gunners in that room, and then unlock an advanced lock door to the right, which leads to a terminal that allows us to deactivate another laser tripwire, some machine gun turrets, and open a nearby wall safe. Once the gunners hear you, they're going to open the door, and once the door is open, you can snipe them from a safe distance. The next room has a series of stairs that lead to different storage rooms that you can explore, but we can't go any further until we take the elevator in the middle of the wall. At the top of the elevator, we find ourselves in a large shaft-like chamber. The terminal directly in front of us allows us to open a security gate where we can access two fusion cores. Even though we are surrounded by a lot of computers, terminals, machinery, and compartments, there is absolutely nothing else to loot on this bottom floor. Instead, we can go out the door and unlock the room to the left, which gets us one more fusion core and a bunch of Rad-X. Then we can head on up the stairs, passing the skeleton of a pre-war scientist, to the next floor where we hear the courser interrogating the gunners.
I don't know the password. I'm telling the truth.
I don't believe you are.
Oh, God. Please, no. No. Please,
all he had to do was tell me the password. Now, are you going to cooperate?
Oh, God. Tell me. God. Okay. Just don't shoot. Let me think.
You. Come here. Are you here for the synth?
I'm here to pick up an order. Two large pepperoni and a calzone. Name is Fuck You.
If you're not here for the synth, then you're here for me. What do you want?
And just who is this synth, anyway?
A fugitive. Runaway Institute property. I'm shutting her down and bringing her back.
Yes. I'm here to help the synth.
And you think I'll just hand her over? To you? You've been tracking me. What do you really want?
I'm here to kill you and take what's inside your head.
That you cannot have.
There is no dialogue option that allows you to avoid a confrontation. Z247 will pop a stealth boy, making it very difficult to kill him unless you kill him in a few hits before he pops the stealth boy. Thankfully, your companion will zone in on him, which makes it easier for you to find him and finish him off.
Damn, that was just starting to have fun.
We can loot the courser chip from the body of Z247 to finish the quest Hunter Hunted. The gunners themselves remain non-hostile.
If you're going to kill me, then do it. I don't want to die.
They don't really have anything interesting to say, and if you kill them, MacCready has nothing to say. This really surprised me. MacCready is a former gunner. I thought he would have something interesting to say if you flat out murder non-violent gunners. Because after all, they are people too. Maybe these two had a change of heart after all of this. But no, he remains silent. Once dead, you can talk with the synth girl through the window, and we learn that her name is K198.
Hey, he deserved to die. I know you're not here for me, but I can't get out. Not on my own. I'm going to have to trust you to help me.
Who are you?
We'll talk once you open the door. I promise I won't run. The guard put the password in a toolbox over there, under the stairs. Use it to gain access to the terminal and open the door.
You can find the key in the red toolbox under the stairs and then unlock the terminal to release K198.
Thank you. I don't know what to say.
Who are you?
My institute designation is K198, but I prefer Jenny. So yes, I'm a synth, if you hadn't already guessed.
Oh, you must not have heard. I'm a superhero. I do this for a living.
I knew they'd send a courser. I just didn't think he'd find me so fast. I think I would have lost him too. But then I was captured by these mercenaries. And all this happened. Thanks again for your help. I'm gonna look for supplies before heading out. And before you ask, no, I don't need any more help. The Commonwealth is unforgiving. I need to make it on my own or I'm dead. Maybe we'll meet again, under better circumstances. I hope we do.
Well, Jenny, as we're supposed to call her, certainly has an independent streak. Even though she got captured by gunners and needed your help to be freed, she certainly doesn't want any more help now. What's interesting is that Jenny describes these gunners as mercenaries. She doesn't describe them as raiders. Raiders kidnap for their own reasons. To torture, convert, or murder for fun. Mercenaries kidnap for other people's reasons, because somebody else needed something from that person, and she described these gunners as mercenaries. Who would hire the gunners to kidnap Jenny? She's not worth anything, unless the employer knew that she was a synth. Then she's worth something. And who finds the most worth in a synth? Why none other than the Institute? I think this may be more evidence that the Institute hired the gunners to retrieve Jenny before dispatching the Courser to kill the gunners solely for your benefit, so that you could get the Courser chip without feeling that you were being manipulated by Father and still find your way into the Institute. You can head up the stairs to loot a fat man and a big chest of end-of-dungeon loot. There's also another mini-nuke hiding under the stairs. And since Jenny said she was gonna stick around and salvage, she does just that. She walks to these big orange filing cabinets and just looks around. At the top of the stairs, you can use the terminal to unlock a door to Cambridge. This leads out to a balcony overlooking the entire city, and MacReady recognizes its beauty.
This is amazing. I've never seen anything so beautiful.
Here we find the pre-war skeleton of a scientist lying next to an ammunition crate, and that's about it. If you're wearing power armor, you can jump on down, but if you're not, you can go back inside and use the elevator, which brings us down to that one elevator on the ground floor that was inactive when we arrived. So, what did we learn from this? Well, we learned that, left to their own devices, gunners will occupy places of strategic importance, loot them of all of their resources, send those resources back to HQ, and then defend the place to use as a headquarters from which to launch further operations. We also learn that they are mercenaries. They do work for other people for money. Somebody hired them to kidnap this girl, Jenny. We don't really know who, but my best guess is that it's the Institute. I can't think of another faction in the game who would want to retrieve a synth. This synth had escaped on its own to seek out the railroad at Bunker Hill, so it couldn't have been the railroad that hired the gunners, and the Brotherhood of Steel just kills synths. They don't want to keep synths alive. So the Brotherhood certainly wouldn't have hired the gunners to kidnap this synth. It's got to be the Institute. And why? In this case, I think to lure you into a false sense of security, making you think that you were really in control. When in reality, Father was in control the entire time, giving you everything you needed to find him. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the full story of Green Tech Genetics and the Hunter/Hunted quest. We only had a few facts to work with here, but I hope that my speculations were informative and thought-provoking. Do you agree or disagree with me? Let me know in the comments section below. I read all of your comments, and I use your comments as inspiration for my future videos. I have a new t-shirt shop, ladies and gentlemen. I've got a bunch of t-shirts that are both Oxhorn and Fallout 4 themed, so if you're interested, check out the link to my Teespring shirt shop in the description below. And if you like what I do and you'd like to support me in a more personal way, consider becoming one of my patrons on Patreon. Patreon subscribers get access to a private channel on my Discord server, as well as a bunch of other cool Oxhorn perks. But more than anything, ladies and gentlemen, I'm just so glad that you're here watching this video with me today. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow morning, as always, bright and early, with a brand new video.